You can think of DNA, genes, and chromosomes as forming a kind of blueprint of life. These are the plans that tell the body how to make things, in this case proteins, which are the body's basic building blocks. But unlike a blueprint for a house where all the information is stored on a flat piece of paper, the blueprint of life has many levels of organization to it. Let's start with DNA, the most basic level. A DNA molecule is made up of a sugar backbone and four flavors of a molecule called a nucleotide. These nucleotides are arranged along the backbone in a unique order. When your body needs a particular protein, it reads the sequence of nucleotides and uses it as a template to make that protein. Moving up a level of organization, we have genes. Genes are long snippets or chunks of DNA. They're also the most basic unit of inheritance. Traits are passed on from parents to children in the form of genes. Genes include other information about building proteins. For example, they tell the body how long a protein should be and how much to make and when to make it. Genes also have directions about where DNA can be edited out to make proteins with different functions. This is how the body makes an estimated 1 million proteins from only 20,000 genes. The next level up is the chromosome. Humans have 46 of these, arranged in pairs. Chromosomes are long strands of DNA wrapped around beach ball-like proteins called histones. Chromosomes contain many genes, along with long stretches of DNA, whose purpose we've yet to figure out. In order to make a protein, DNA has to be unwound from its histones. This is controlled by a process called acetylation, and it's just another level of control the body has over the production of proteins. So as you can see, the blueprint for our bodies is quite well organized. If only that was the case for the rest of our lives. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm Eric Olson.